I'm going collect, release. See that release right there? I'm not going at the ball and then try to push that at the target. So where do you want to release it to? So you want to basically release it just like you did there, left edge of that yellow cone, right?
Yeah.
And hold it against the center line?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Just like that, Moo.
Just like that.
You just have to picture it.
Yeah.
That's awesome. So we're running out of fairway there, 370. So two options for accuracy with the driver. You can tee it up nice and high. That's our number 18. And you can see how the ball is well above the top of the club.
Yeah.
Now, Moo enjoys this because it allows him to hit the ball lower without hitting the ground. So you actually can get, you know, a nice arc leveling out about here. And then you're squeezing that ball at the tree line, right? And then you're keeping it out of the wind because, I mean, it's staying a long time in the air, so we got to keep it out of the wind.
That's right.
So show me at, you know, at address what that would look like. So the ball you just hit, that would be your setup, correct?
Correct,
yeah. Okay, so now take your backswing and stop. And now come on down in slow motion. So notice that angle of attack is slightly on the way down. There's impact, and then there's the tee tumbling, and you can see the low point is right about here, right?
Yeah.
Now, if I'm driving for accuracy, I like to hit it a little bit lower.
Okay.
So if I put it on this tee for you,
yeah,
right? Go ahead and set up to that.
Yeah.
I want you to set up like you're setting up to a fairway wood. So that might be a little too far back in your stance there, Moo. So okay. I want you to put the center of the club in the center of your feet and the ball forward of that. Move it more that way. Yeah. Okay. So do you feel now that the center of the club's in the center of your feet?
Yeah.
Okay. So if you catch it as the club is bottoming out, all you want to do here is hit it like a three wood. So you're just going to follow the ground with the sole of the club.
Right.
So as you're following the ground with the sole of the club, the bottom of the club steadies the head.
Yeah.
And you're you know, so I don't have your strength.
Uh-huh.
I mean, you look at how accurate that last shot was. That was incredible. And at 67 feet in the air, you're carrying that 343, dude.
That's fun.
That's fun. If we were going to do the opposite and we wanted to tag it on the way up, my club is in the center. My ball is forward. So the club comes up, comes back down center stance, and then goes back up again. So I want to feel like I'm going to be flicking the tee on the way up. So notice my full extension is past the ball. You can see Tony Finau here, and he likes to tee it a little low. Same for Kitayama, who's doing really well right now on tour. They're only teeing it off like the last one I showed you, and they're following the ground. But you can see that they're collecting the ball there and releasing the ball there. So if I set up to my ball here, that feels like I've got it on the way up. Backswing. See my lag? There's my battering ram. The club is coming down at this point here, and now it feels like I'm going to be flicking the tip of the tee on the way up. There. Release. So notice my release now. In order for the club to catch up to my hands, this is a big one. I'm going collect, release. See that release right there? I'm not going at the ball and then try to push that at the target. This is what I see so many of you doing. you're going hit the ball and then try to push it that way. And what inevitably happens is when you're in that direction, here we go. So this is me catching it on the way up. I'm going to go for the ball. See where I'm going now? Now I'm releasing at the ball on the way down. I'm causing it to really hit down on the ball. I'm going to have these big spinners. I'm going to be hitting the ground. So many of you are, you know, pop flying the ball and going underneath the ball at that height. I know many of you are scared of that one and you much prefer that shorter tee. But even with the shorter tee, you're still gouging the ground. That's you going after a golf ball. So if I'm going to play a little fade here, I want to feel like I'm going to be catching the tip of that tee on the way up and to the left. So notice where I'm starting my club. Take it back. Now I'm going to the left of the intermediate point. Left, 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 but on the way up. See how the club is going to bottom out here? And then I'm flicking the tip of the tee on the way up and to the left of that intermediate point. So now I'm fully in understanding on how this is going to work, and I'm just going to let momentum sling the tip of that tee up there.
That looks really good.
I can't do it any better than that. Ha! See, that's what I'm going, yeah! But then, Moo, you're all the way up, all the way. So we're looking at 155 ball speed compared to 190 ball speed. Whereas just 2 short years ago, that was Moo. And that can be, you know, the amount of improvement can easily be there for you. If you're used to going at the ball, and we change that from at the ball to at the target, that's going to be a very significant plus for you. Now, if your grip is too weak with the driver, notice Moo's grip. Look at that sucker. We got all four knuckles shown right here, and the club face is slightly closed. And so many of you look at that, and it's like, what is going on there? Are you guys nuts? So if Moo swings at the ball, yeah, of course he's going to hook it. But Moo swinging through the ball and at the target, that's where the money is over there. So show me a backswing and stop. Show me your slow motion that's going to deliver this into the wall. Look where his hands are. So now that his hands are more forward, look at the club head. So now Moo is delivering a club head that collects the ball slightly open. And when the ball comes off the face, it's right about here because that ball stays along on the face for a long period of time, especially when you got 150 plus miles an hour like this guy does. So then the ball is going to spring off the face at this point, and then he chases it with his release. So show me a practice swing right next to it, Moo. That's through the ball, people. Amazing.
Yeah.
Let's see one more. So the picture is, we're starting the ball left edge of this gold tee, and we're holding it with a nice draw against that center line. Yes, sir. Just a little overcooked.
Yeah.
But boy, oh boy.
Dang, missed the fairway.
350 in the rough with no roll. How about that?
I cut that pretty good.
That was really good, man. Yeah. 193 ball speed.
Yeah.
So had you hit the fairway 340 carry, that would have been another 370, 375.
And the peak height's perfect, 56. You know.
That's your stinger, man.
Yeah.
Isn't that cool?
Yeah, that's fun.
So we hope you guys enjoyed that, and we'll see you in the next video. All the best. Oh my.
All right, so it's rolling.
I'm dialing in my intensities right now on the Katalyst. So we got, some really good contractions in the quads, the hamstrings, the glutes we could go a little bit more on. Oh my goodness. My chest is really vibrating right now. Okay, glutes are good, lower back's good. Middle back, I need some more. Gotta crank up the middle back. Oh yeah, that QL joint. Come on, baby! We're gonna dig into that QL. Oh my goodness. This feels amazing. Holy! Arms, a little bit more. You see it?
I can't see it, but I'm sure the muscles are contracting.
Watch. Incredible. This is incredible. Okay, so chest, I'm at 70, arms at 80, upper back 100, middle back 140, lower back 140, abs. Oh, abs, I'm not feeling my abs. Hang on a second, where's my six pack? Hang on. Woo-hoo-hoo! Holy this is giving me a little tingle now.
To get in that rhythm, that mental space of focusing in.
Oh, so it starts slow, yeah.
That's how we do it here at Katalyst. 4 seconds.
Okay,
here
it's picking
go.
Up.
Two more bases, and then we're going to continue our warm-up with a little bit
of
circling. Okay, one more base, and then we're going to be doing big shoulder circles all the way around here, but one more base.
Oh, yes.
With that butt, with those quads, a little bit. Okay, now your shoulder circles. You're going to stand straight here, arms by your side, and bring those arms slowly forward all the way up and around, okay? We'll go a little bit faster this time. You're going to try to get a full circle all the way around.
Oh, my gosh.
Just like that, starting from the bottom and going forward. Bringing the backs of your hands up toward the sky and then looping around. One foot back, one foot in front, hands up by your temples, just like this, and get a little bounce right
Got
here.
Some biceps going right
okay,
there.
You're gonna start to really ramp up the power through this one. While you
I think I gave it a little too much, bro.
Here we go, hands up. Light bouncing stance, just like that. Two more reps in this boxing
right
stance here.
Low?
Two lines.
Very good.
There you go.
All right. Okay, resume workout.
And we're gonna get back to our base after this. Back, just like that. Two jabs.
Okay.
Here we go, breathe through them. Perfect. Very nice. Now with a little bit more resistance, here we go, through the impulse. One, two. Beautiful. And then always end in that stance with those hands up, light on the feet. Two more jabs, here we go. And then one more set before we collect ourselves. Bounce around a little bit more. Let's go. Two jabs. Very good. Okay.
Feel all the way through.
Back to the base
really?
Here.
Yeah.
Hand and one rep here. Here we go. Steady breaths. Just like that. Hands up. Drive out. Very nice.
I just had to man up, boo. That's all I had to do, man.
Hands back up. Punching straight forward at you here.
That's it. Keep it up.
And two, right down the middle. Here's our weave, okay?
Ooh, weave.
So you get back in our stance. Hands are up, and you're gonna dip down with me, and then dip down again, okay? Very slight turn at the bottom of this dip. So you dip, turn, come back up. Dip, turn, come back up. And all you're doing is you're making your opponent miss your head. That punch is coming, you're going right underneath that punch. Another punch is coming, you're going right underneath that punch.
This is gonna be good for the squatting and the swing.
Four straight punches, just like that. Shake out those arms, bounce around a little bit. Hands back up, jab, cross, jab.
The slower
cross.
You do
Very
it,
nice.
The harder it hits.
Slow ramp up, here we go. Jab, cross, jab, cross. Beautiful.
Wow,
try to drive your
so
shoulder
good.
Into these punches. That's it. Three more reps. Hands together, butt back. Two more. Almost there. Okay, last one, last increase. I lied. One more increase. Here we go. Butt down. Woo! You made it. Great work. Fantastic job. Working through all that technique.
Oh my gosh.
There was a lot to move through, but again, stay
I can't
with
wait
it.
To do it again.
We're going to come back to this. We're going to use all this again.
This is it. This is the most fun I've ever had in a workout, bar none. This is, it's over. I've now found my way to work out, and I can't wait to suit up in a couple of days and do another one. So I figured I'll do the boxing again a couple of times and really get used to that and then dive into the other workouts. So with that, Shawn out.